What's up, everybody? How's it going?
Since a lot of you guys from up above actually subscribed to the channel, I didn't even ask for you to subscribe, but you did it anyways. Freaking mad lads, alright? Some people in my last video asked, how's the state of right to repair here in Brazil? And I'm here to tell you a little story that happened to me on my last job when I worked at fixing medical equipment. I mean, long story short, right to repair here in Brazil is just as bad as you may think. We do have some protective laws. Like, companies are obligated to have replacement parts for machines that have been released within 4 years, I think. But that's pretty much it. You, as an end customer, sometimes cannot even buy these parts. You have to be an authorized technician, and being an authorized technician here in Brazil is really freaking bad, in my opinion, because you have to abide by their rules and everything. So it's not really worth it. But yeah, we don't have any schematics, we don't have any board views, we don't have pretty much anything. Sometimes you can get replacement parts from them, but that's really like rare. Unfortunately, that's just how it is. Okay, I want to talk about the time that I had to fix a surgical table, and not any ordinary surgical table. This was a really nice and expensive one. I think it was like $100,000 or something. If you translate that to our currency here in Brazil, which is reais, that equals to about, you know, a little over $500,000 reais. Imagine paying that for just a surgical table. Really freaking expensive. Anyway, okay. So there's this one day we were at the shop just fixing random stuff, and we get a call from one of the medical centers here in the city, and they say, hey, one of our main surgical tables stopped working. These places, they usually have like a local technician that can do like random stuff, you know, fix electrical wallets and tight some screws and everything, but not really people that are capable of fixing this sort of thing. So, okay, you know, the surgical table is leaking oil. We need you guys to check it out. Fine. We go there. It's a very, very big table, completely made out of stainless steel. Like, the thing is, it's beautiful. Actually, really freaking nice. We open it up, and lo and behold, there's like a pool of oil in the base of it, almost soaking the electronics and the batteries and stuff. This table, I think it had like 6 lead acid batteries in it. It needs to have batteries, like, in case if the power goes out and you're in the middle of a surgery, the table still needs to work, so the thing has batteries. And unfortunately, there was just oil everywhere. We did a little poking, and it turns out the main cylinder, you know, the main piston that makes the table go up and down, was faulty. It was leaking. I think it was a gasket problem. This was way more than a year ago, so I don't remember all the details, but I'm pretty sure it was just a gasket problem. And we were like, okay, maybe we can replace this piston with a new one. And that day, we didn't have enough tools to actually disassemble the table. So we came back another day, and after like 2.5 hours, we were able to take out that center piston. It was very, very difficult. That table had a lot of magnetic encoders and hoses. We also had to drain the rest of the oil that was in there. So it's like really difficult stuff. So fine, we took the piston out. We called the manufacturer of the table, and we were like, okay, so we're a repair shop. This hospital called us because they were having this table problem. It's leaking oil. We figured out that the main piston is bad. How much is for a new piston? They didn't answer that question right away. At first, they had, you know, they asked like who we were, what we were doing, the model of the table and all that. And then they just said, sorry, we cannot sell you that piston because we don't make it anymore. That table is too old. I'm pretty sure it was just like 3 to 4 to 5 years old. It's not that old. It's a very, very expensive table, and you're telling me that you don't even have any replacement parts for it? And not all that, they just said, you know, maybe the hospital can buy a new table. You want to see the catalog? At that point, we knew that we're not going to have any help from the manufacturer, so we took a look around the city to see who can, you know, fix pistons. And there was just one shop, one place that can fix a fucking piston. We brought it there. The guy took a look at the piston and said, oh, okay, yeah, no, that sounds like very simple. Just leave it here. We will call you when we figure out what's wrong with it. A couple days passes, they call us up and they said, hey, that's what's wrong with it. I think it was really just a gasket, and that's how much it's going to be to fix it. Awesome. We took that quote, we passed it on to the hospital. The hospital approved the quote, and we got a finished up piston. Just like that, from just a random shop around the city. They disassembled the piston, they changed a couple of O-rings, changed a couple of gaskets, and it was brand new again. Simple, right? Not quite. The next day, we went there to actually put the piston back on. Okay, we put the piston back on, we got everything lined up, I put the magnetic encoders back, and that table has like a big roll of solenoid valves for the pumps and the oil system. The solenoid valve blocks are made of this really, really soft aluminum, pure aluminum. And the hoses for the hydraulics has these screws, and those screws are made out of stainless steel. Okay, fine. But you know what happens when you just screw a little bit tighter a stainless steel screw into a aluminum block? Yeah, I think you know what happened. Those threads on that block were already like fucked up. I think someone tried looking at it first, other than us. I think the hospital actually called the company that makes the table, and I think they sent a couple of technicians, but when they arrived here, just said, eh, nah, can't do anything. I think might as well just buy a new table. And I'm not joking. I did like the lightest freaking tightening, and that thing stripped. At that point, we knew that the nightmare was just only beginning. We got that block, we called the company again, and they said, hey, do you guys sell the solenoid valves for these tables? We were so freaking naive. We were expecting just, hey, yeah, of course, we do sell them. Of course, that's not what happened. They said, again, that it's an old part, they don't sell it, they don't make it anymore. Buy a new table! Okay, we had this solenoid block that was completely stripped, and we couldn't even buy another one. So we were like, oh, god damn it, like, now this, what else are we going to do? We got in contact with a machine shop that has actually done a couple of services with us. And the guy is like very skilled. He has a very nice lathe. Very, very skilled person. We brought that solenoid valve to him. He looked at it and is like, oh, the threads are stripped, right? Like, yeah, can you fix that? Can you give me a day? We're like, holy shit, is this guy actually going to save us? Turns out he bored out the hole and made a threaded insert made out of stainless steel. And that thing looked so perfect that we couldn't even tell where the aluminum part ended and the threaded insert started. Like, it was machined so smooth, so perfectly. We're like, oh my Jesus, you saved us, dude. You freaking saved us. Anyway, we paid him. A day later, we got back into the hospital. We put that solenoid valve back in. We changed all the old rings in that surgical table. We pumped it full of oil, we powered it up, and it worked perfectly first time. First try. We were like high-fiving each other. We were doing everything. It was so freaking cool and so freaking nice to fix that surgical table. Like, that was one of the biggest challenges that we faced fixing medical equipment. That was like one of the biggest ones. And we did it. We made it. And I'm pretty sure that table still works to this day 100%. Now, why did that happen? Because of independent repair. Because of the small machine shop. Because of the random guy that fixes pistons. That's why we need independent repair. That's why we need right to repair. Imagine if we just called the manufacturer and they said, hey, we got the piston. We got the solenoid valve. That's how much it's going to be. We can ship it to you in the next 3 days. Things would have been so much easier. If we went through the manufacturer's route, that $100,000 surgical table wouldn't be fixed. That would go to landfill. Because I'm pretty sure we cannot even sell it as parts. We cannot do that. It baffles me. It's really, really freaking dumb. And I don't get it. I know you want to sell me a newer table and all that, but come on, man. It's $100,000. People say that we need right to repair for electronics, for smartphones, for laptops and all that. But I say we need right to repair for fucking everything. Imagine if your wife or your kid or your son got into a very serious accident and he needed surgery and the surgical table just didn't work. And the manufacturer just doesn't give a damn. He just say, spend, I don't know, maybe $200,000 this time and maybe you won't get one. That's bad. You know, you would get like a little better model. Doesn't make any sense. That's why we need right to repair. And thankfully, right to repair is spreading all around the world. We are already kind of looking into it here in Brazil. It's in the very early stages of it. But I just hope that someday everything will be perfect. You can just call the manufacturer and ask for a replacement part. Especially for these very expensive machines. Like x-ray machines. We fixed a couple x-ray machines, but it was only like electrical problems. We didn't really need any replacement parts. Imagine if we needed like a new x-ray tube. Where the hell am I gonna find that? There's no way. But yeah, I think that's pretty much it for this video. I hope you enjoyed the little story, and I hope that little story puts a little seed in your head on why we need right to repair and why right to repair is so important. Not just for me or for you, but for everyone else, especially in the medical spectrum of things, you know, medical repair and everything. I'm gonna be trying to make a lot more videos in English for you guys now. I know my Brazilian viewers are not gonna like that, but since I got a lot more subscribers, I need to make content for you guys as well. So I'm gonna try to do that. All right, thank you for watching. I'm not gonna close this video with, I hope you learned something, because that's not my thing. So I'm just gonna end it with me walking towards the camera being an idiot.